Well, a very good morning and welcome back to the Imagine Cruising 2023 World Indoor Bowls Championships live from Potter's Resorts here in Hopton-on-Sea. Another World Open singles match for you. Coming up now, it's Darren Burnett taking on the New Zealand qualifier of Colin Rogan. So let's have a look at what we have coming up for the rest of today. Well, just after lunch at 2 o'clock will be Greg Harlow taking on Jamie Walker, Jamie Chesney taking on John Wilson, and the evening game for your entertainment at 7:30 will be Alex Marshall, MBE, who will take on Mark Royal. So let's have a look at the match officials for this one then. Its marker is Sue Mates, the umpire is Bernie Hill, and on the shot clock is Greg Brown. So let's go live to the portable rink and join one of our MCs, Mr. Jack Jenkins.
Thank you very much, Jason. Yes, another lovely crowd in here in the International Arena. So let's welcome out the players. The first out for this match, we have a player from New Zealand. He is a previous Scottish Open qualifier and making his debut here at the World Championships. Please give it up for Colin Rogan. His opponent for this match is a former Welsh, Scottish and International Open champion, as well as a previous World Open, Mixed Pairs and World Singles Championship titles. Please put your hands together for number 15 in the world, Darren Burnett. I will hand you up to Graham Irving Cole and Jason Parkinson in the commentary box.
Thank you very much, Jack. Once again, good morning. Welcome back to the Imagine Cruising World Indoor Bowls Championships. Another good singles tie on the cards for you here. New Zealand qualifier, Colin Rogan. He's qualified before for the World Bowls Tour events. Played very well in the open pairs a few days ago.
Jack lands 28 and a half metres.
Joining me in the commentary box again, Mr. Graham Irving Cole.
Thanks very much, Jason, for your more than sympathetic introduction. Yeah, as always, if you do have any questions you need to ask, if we can answer them, just pop it into Facebook. We'll do our best to answer it. And if we don't know the answer, we'll go and try and find out.
Inches in front of Jack High.
Second ball by Colin.
No. Oh, she's quite close for shot.
Flo's asking where we're playing these events. We're at one of the Potter's Resorts. They've now got two. It's the Hopton-on-Sea Resort, fabulous resort, which is in Norfolk in the United Kingdom. Not far from Great Yarmouth.
Two green.
See, here they have a brand new new resort, Five Lakes.
Darren, a shake of the head there. Colin's first ball up into the head.
Glad you're enjoying the stream, Susan, there, listening to us doing the housework. Glad we're keeping you busy.
Three green.
Well, there are good ball by Colin.
Yeah, certainly a good start.
Darren will just be trying to come in through the gap of these between these two green balls. Still struggling a bit for weight. Trying to drift down here, add to his tally, apply the pressure a wee bit to Darren. Opting for the cover shot, giving himself back ball. Just changing his hand, looking to drift into the white. Just to kick down a gear here. Enough for second shot.
Okay. One shot, Colin Rogan.
Darren saving a couple of shots there with his last delivery.
Set score 0-1, first end. Jack length, 27 metres.
Colin, two good lines with his first two balls. Slightly on the weight. Darren doesn't like this. But
that's Darren. You can never tell with Darren's mannerisms.
One red.
Stuart.
He certainly looked as though he didn't like it.
Stuart calls him Churchill.
Thank you. is to hold here. Stay up.
Closer, favour the green.
And Colin's last ball. Favourite at the moment for shot.
Two red. One inch.
Was it? Just needs to hold to get up past that one. Oh.
Two shots, Darren Burnett.
So, Darren picks up a two here in this second
Set
end.
Score 2-1 after two ends.
And this best of a nine end set.
Colin Rogan from New Zealand, from Rothesay Bay area, retired.
Shot length 24 metres.
Two children, Natasha and Simon, plus their grandchild, little Fiona. Plays out of Browns Bay Bowling Club. Won the New Zealand PBA Scottish International Open qualifier for 4 years out of the last five. It's not bad at all.
There's a gap there of 9 inches. One red. Favour two.
Well, it's on a good line. Just pace required. Needs
well
to be.
Played.
Yeah, it was him.
Two red and a measure for third.
Well, could be tempted to play down the forehand here with quite a bit of pace. You know, there's a solid on the jack, should run through with it.
Yep.
Short ball, anything full, could get that kind of contact as well.
I wouldn't imagine it would be back from this, though. No, he's drawn. So we're both wrong again.
Just think it's a low percentage ball, but if he plays it well,
he's very close here. Just unfortunate, fell out the wrong way.
Two to red.
Two shots, yeah. Darren Burnett.
Set score 4-1 after 3 ends. That length 25 metres.
So, chance here for Colin just to take advantage of the slack opening ball by Darren.
Yeah, it's played it well. Great start.
Excellent correction by Darren.
One red. Last ball, an inch and a half in front of Jack High. 10-inch gap at the back. You are 2.5 inches gap.
Darren should be able to build up a picture of roughly where those bowls are situated in the head.
Very close here. This is to keep turning.
Two red.
Could play the forehand or the backhand for the split of the two.
Split the two balls, yeah. Close.
Oh, it's a good hit. Wanted the split ideally, but still a good hit. The jack will just be spotted.
Two green.
Oh.
One red. One shot, Colin Rogan.
Set score.
Good end there for both players. Colin did that really important hit and recover shot. Sometimes when it's just building up, it's easier just to try and open it up. You've still got to play it though, your last ball. You've still got to drop all that pace out your arm. But he's done it well.
That length, 26 and a half metres.
So Colin just slightly overplayed there, first delivery. Good opening first ball from Darren.
Gap 5.5 inches. One red.
Still just
just missing the weight. Line's reasonably okay.
Well, good ball from Darren. It's just dragged it away from his other one.
One red. The gap, 2 inches.
Okay. down the other hand, the forehand. I mean, if he can get to Darren's ball, ideally gets to the jack. Not too far away with this. Will it bend? Oh, unlucky.
Ball's in.
Ball, yes. Good ball. So we'll have a quick look. Maybe not so quick look. Must be closer than what it looks.
Shot here.
I favour red.
Get a chuck underneath that.
Hungry. One shot, Colin Rogan.
Well, we'll never know, I guess. Unfortunately, Darren's bowl has fallen over.
Set score 4-3 after 5 ends.
Each bowl you get the 30 seconds, don't you?
30 seconds.
From when the bowl comes to rest, but you've got to ask for the 30 seconds. They'll be keeping an eye on the watch as they do that.
That length 29.5 metres.
Three feet short of Jack High.
Just have a look at that rule that someone asked regarding the 30 seconds. It says if either player desires, 30 seconds must elapse before the measuring process is started. The player must clearly indicate to a marker they desire to allow for the 30 seconds to elapse. It's always good to have a little look, isn't it? I like the wording of rules.
Doesn't like it again. I mean, his body language would say he doesn't like it. Just, I don't know if that's getting to him, the fact that the ball fell out there. Just needs to try and forget about it quickly.
Three green.
It's going to come up here.
Yeah.
you think he'll maybe play through this?
Well, just I think that's what he's looking at. Yeah. I think he's looking at distances and angles there. Yeah. There's not a massive head. I mean, you could almost run under it on the backhand. You can nearly get a clean jack. If you're slightly under the head, you get the second shot and back to the shot bowl.
Mm-hmm. Darren has four timeouts left.
Yeah.
I think he'll be just looking at the angles to decide what kind of pace. I mean, Darren does normally play a lot firmer than most.
Just to get that frustration out of his body as well.
Yeah, maybe. No. He's playing the backhand, so I think he might just play straight through for the jack or get 1-2 on the green bowls. Colin needs to cover the back position.
He's to remember the shot clock as well.
Yes. Needs to get a move on. Needs to get a move on. Oh, never worried. Oh. Never worried.
That was close. It's that close, even my pacemaker sped up then.
I thought you were just cold.
Paul Green.
Will that tempt Darren into the draw? I mean, if he goes again and misses, that's a very loose four, isn't it? I mean, if he drops a two here, it's not a massive issue. Now he's going again.
It's going again, yep.
Needs to make contact then. He's underneath again, is he?
So he's underneath again. Oh dear.
Four shots, Colin Rogan.
Set score 4-7 after 6 ends.
All credit to Colin Rogan there as well, though. You know, just getting on with it and just keeping plugging away.
Yep. That's 3 ends on the bounce. He's won now.
That length 29 metres.
Start again by Colin. Certainly a good line here. Slightly over on the pace.
Played.
slight adjustment. Well, it was perfect with his first delivery.
One red.
Well played again. Yeah, two excellent bowls.
Two red.
Let's play down the forehand now, I think, if he's wanting to get the shot.
Let's go into the forehand here.
Just ever so slightly wide, wasn't it?
Yeah, his weight was correct for what he was looking for.
Well, it's all in his pace. It's down to the jack. Oh, just lacking 18 inches. Just
pulled up short, yeah.
Two shots, Darren Burnett.
Set score 6-7 after 7 ends. That length 24 metres.
Just no scent this time. Just down to pace from there as he made the adjustment here.
Yeah, both players just struggling at the moment. It's a lot shorter than they have been playing. Just over
two red
minimum length, but still two to red.
Three red.
Wow. Left the door open again.
Colin won't want to be losing a loose four here. Darren lost one earlier in the set.
Yeah, Darren will be looking at trying to get this ball within about a foot. He'll want to count this end. The others will be a bonus at this stage. Yeah, it's well played.
Forehand. Timeout called. Colin, you have four timeouts remaining.
How's the pace?
Pace looks better. That was definitely a big ball there.
Yeah, one to Darren, I think.
One shot, Colin Rogan.
Oh, nice. Got in. Yeah. Big ball. I thought the other ball was the nearest ball.
Certainly looked set from score, our angle, the red ball looked closest.
Yep, Darren will be disappointed with that. So one for Colin. Two ahead going into the final end of this first set. Thanks for joining us once again here at the World Indoor Championships. Lots of games coming up for you today. Two more games for you after lunch, and then one this evening. Tomorrow we will see the quarterfinals of the World Mixed Pairs
that
begin.
Length, 27 and a half metres.
And tomorrow's my last day, Jason. You'll be pleased to know. I know you'll be delighted.
Heartbroken. Absolutely heartbroken.
Yeah. Good opener by Colin to start this final end of this first set.
I notice how you didn't say I'm swapping you for a younger and much better looking model. Emily Ferguson will be joining us in the commentary for the mixed and the ladies match play.
That wouldn't be difficult to swap me for a younger model and much better looking model. That wouldn't be hard. I've always known I've had a face for radio. Yep, so.
Down the backhand, play for the drag of the jack. Oh, look it. Oh, I think he's connected with his back ball.
He's taking his back ball out as well.
Been lucky there, yeah. I mean, he did get one away, but it's straight into that ball he had just hanging on the green.
So he can now only draw the set.
One green.
Two
So Colin Rogan should know now. At worst, they'll get half a point. Short.
Colin just needs to beat that last bowl of Darren Burnett's. He needs us two. He'll be needing to arrive on the shot bowl with a tiny bit of pace, which is difficult. So I think if he gets one just in between Darren's and the jack, that should be enough to secure this first set.
Slightly deeper. I'm not sure what he's done with that.
I
don't think there was a necessity to go as deep as that.
No, he need. Like I say, he needs both of his to yeah. count. He should have just covered, I think, that.
Just in front of Darren's bowl gives yeah. him. Makes it harder for Darren. Chance here for Darren just to move the short bowl just maybe a couple of feet here.
Just wide, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. yeah. Not to be.
One green and
so
first set
Colin,
Colin
Rogan,
Rogan
from New Zealand takes this first set 9-6. Once again, thanks for joining us at this Wounded Door Bowls Cruises. We've got a brand new sponsor on board this year, and we're going to have a quick look at why Imagine Cruising is certainly more than just a cruise. Fantastic holiday packages there from Buenos Aires to the Swiss Alps to the Canadian Rockies. There's certainly something for everyone.
One red.
Nearly, just slightly underneath. Thought he was going to get just a piece of that jack. Darren will just play down to his own bowl.
Three. One down. One red. Two green.
Again, just didn't get down with the pace.
Two shots, Colin Rogan.
Set score 0-2, first end.
Making comment as well, Jason, about trying to get here next year. It looks if you get the opportunity and you can manage to come next year, I would highly recommend.
And 28.5 meters.
And soak up the atmosphere and soak up the way that this is all set up at Potter's Resorts. It's absolutely fantastic.
Certainly is. Playing quite well, Colin, from New Zealand.
Is Jack,
yeah.
New Zealand. I put my teeth back in.
That was my teeth you had in there.
He's playing quite well, isn't he?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's just getting on with it. He's just getting on with the game and...
Good reply as well, just locked it in.
Said Colin, he's just carrying on the form that he had in the pairs game. He had a really good game in the pairs game as well.
One green.
One red.
One green.
playing drawn weight here. Just reaches his own shot ball. Very close again here, Jason. Doesn't want any movement for Jack.
He's got to the seed,
yeah.
Didn't he?
Yeah.
One green.
Question there from Peter Gordon. How long is the portal rink? It is about 35 and a half metres in length. Playing distance is 29 and a half metres tee to tee, so the full length jack, but the rink itself is 35 and a half metres in length.
That's covered that spot if Darren decides to play with any sort of weight. Drawing weight here, just trying to come down to slight movement in the jack would be good. I think he's cut his line again.
Yep, he has.
One shot, Colin Rogan.
Set score 0-3 after 2 eights.
Quick question from VJ there out in New Zealand asking how he gets involved with the qualifiers for this. I've just posted the link for you in the comments for the New Zealand page on our website. Just click that. It's got all the information of how you become a member of the Professional Bowling Association New Zealand branch. Get in touch with them and they'll certainly help you and welcome you.
That lands 29 and a half metres.
Here again.
There he is.
Yeah, the tee is, there's 3 metres between the tee and the ditch. Just this portable surface.
Just struggling a little bit, isn't he, for his pace?
Yes, yeah.
3 green.
Darren's going straight through. Oh. Unbelievable. Straight through the hole. My goodness, look at that. I mean, from that angle there, it looks even more unbelievable.
And regardless of experience or how many times you've been successful at this level, for everybody it does become a very lonely place if things are not going your way. All credit to Colin Logan, though, or Colin Rogan. He's been playing really good bowls. Self best back cover here.
Go in again. Yes, you know.
Be, yeah.
Couple away.
Yeah.
One shot, Colin Rogan.
So a 4-0 lead for the New Zealander.
Set
Colin
score
Rogan.
0-4 after 3 ends.
Darren needs just to reset now. Just play straight back into this set. It's very important. Ranking points as well, obviously, up for grabs. 10 points for the first round, so he'll be wanting to get some extra points. He's sat down at
length, 28 and a half metres.
15th, I think, about the 14th, 15th area. Obviously, as people are playing, people are getting more points. Mark Royal's just outside of the top 16 at the moment, but he has still got to play this evening. I think from memory there's about 13 points difference, I think, between Darren and Mark. Right, chance here now.
Usually wayward bowl from Colin in his first delivery. Okay, good adjustment.
Hungry.
Get his nose in front.
Two.
Well, that's much better.
Two red.
Track.
Just too quick, is it? Unless it gets back to the jack.
Maybe second shot if it falls out.
One red.
Height's good, it's all on the pace.
Because the green ball just moves it slightly, could bring in the front ball again.
Oh, we'll sit it in. I'd call for the chocks quickly.
Yep.
This time he's called
two shots
for
down
the
Burnett.
Chocks to be placed. Oh, happy with it.
Let's go 2-4 after four ends.
So the comeback begins. A double there, bringing the mat right up. He'll play 23-24 metres. Needs to reach the tee. Has he gone far enough? I'm not quite sure how much is left at the mat.
That length 23.5 metres.
Yeah, it's just enough. Yeah, you can see just a big dot there.
Yeah, that's. Played here.
That's more like it.
Yep, certainly back to it. We know that Darren can play.
Quick question there from David Thomas. Do participants get accommodation? Yep, everything's provided when you arrive on site. Not just the accommodation, all the food and drink is free and all the entertainment that comes with the resort as well. Snooker, table tennis, bowls, crazy golf. Golf.
There's loads of bowling.
Ten pin bowling.
Tabletop curling.
You're just listing the you're just listing the sports. You beat me out. I know what you're doing.
Two red.
Sly.
Out today. Slightly overplayed it again, so chance here for Darren to draw for third shot.
Yep, the change of tactics here by playing short but the other way around, so bringing the mat right up and playing towards the pin, certainly working.
a good track.
Yeah, gets down to the green.
Freeway.
So, far better end from Darren Burnett.
Colin just has to go back and play the draw, I'd say. It's the target's quite small. It's a draw either hand, you know, forehand down to the shot ball, backhand he can get down to either ball. Might be playing pace at this, you know. Might be actually going to hit it.
Yep. So, a three for Darren Burnett. Gives him a
three shots, Darren Burnett.
In this second set.
Set score 5-4 after five ends.
Question about the prize money. I'm not actually quite certain what each level gets, if you wish, each round gets, because there's so many different events on. I know there's the total prize money is £131,000. Winner of this event gets £50,000.
Chat then 25.5 metres.
Start-ish from Colin, just a couple of feet.
So that he was up with his first.
Your first ball's 20 inches short of jack high. This ball's half an inch through jack high. One red. Two red.
He's been caught out with the mat up the rink.
Three
Darren just needs to find his way past those green balls. Edge. Yep.
Three red.
A little bit of pressure here. Certainly won't want to drop a three.
Down to pace and then kiss through.
Yeah, he's going to sail by, isn't he?
So another three for Darren Burnett.
Three shots, Darren Burnett.
That gives him an 8-4 lead. That's second
set. Score 8-4 after six ends.
Yeah, scored eight shots in the last three ends, so he'll just keep plugging away.
Length 25 metres.
Question, can someone in South America or Brazil get involved, or Argentina way? Well, it's all about having a PBA branch, so there isn't a PBA branch in those areas of the world at the moment. Your nearest would be America. They play out of California, normally their PBA qualifiers. However, if there is a big catchment area in where you play, you can contact us and with a view to setting up a PBA branch. This certain obviously stipulations what a branch consists of. But if you think you can get, you know, say 40, 48 players to form a branch, then you can message us and we will do our best to help you. Go to worldbowlstour.org for all our contact details, and like we say, we can do what we can to try and make it happen.
Yep, good stuff, Jason, the work that you've done.
Well, we're always in talks, you know, we're trying to get more people involved. We mentioned it the other day, didn't we, about in talks with the Falkland Islands, North Cyprus and India. Also had a couple of email conversations the other day with a couple of friends in Malaysia.
Bong green. That's 7 inches short of jack high. And you went through 14 inches.
Question for Gary Hood, why North Cyprus and not South Cyprus? Because they're two separate organisations and it's North Cyprus that have approached us. Well played again here.
Yes.
Two green.
Darren just asking the official at the side of the rink how many timeouts he's still got available, which is why he then went back down to the head. Just have a look. He's looking at that the plant there, the green bowl plant. I think it catches the jack. Now, the re-spot is just underneath
Darren
the scoreboard
three
there, as
remaining.
You can see it, right where the middle of the scoreboard are between the two sets. So he'll be looking. The trouble is, it's whether the plant then makes contact with his own bowl.
Yeah, if there is contact with his own ball thought, just at that angle there, would it be pushing it? It'd be pushing it, you know, to the three spot. I don't know.
Depends on the pace. Yeah.
Likes it.
I think his ball's going out the ring.
Yeah. Depending on where the jack is.
I think it's just to the right of the centre spot, isn't it? About a foot.
Yeah. So it's going to be one down like that.
Bon green.
So a huge chance here to get it back,
an extra shot here and get two. Needs to stop.
Oh my goodness, don't say he's lost that. Dear.
Okay.
Yep.
One shot, Colin Rogan.
Well, could be a costly mistake that he had. Almost 3 yards.
Set score 8-5 after 7 ends.
Just being advised by the umpire that the front edge of the mat needs to be on the tee.
Yep.
Jack length 29.5 meters.
Full length jack this time.
The jack up. Yes, good adjustment from Colin. Can you get the jack as well? Oh, he's got a slight touch. Still one green.
One green.
One green.
So that's the red ball, he's good.
And 2 green.
Height looks very good. It's all about the pace, I think.
Yep, needs to run the last wee bit. Needs to keep coming.
It's in.
Over
the, yep, well, well played.
One red.
Big ball.
Timeout called. Colin has three timeouts remaining.
He's got to play to flip it away.
Yep.
Straight for the bowl, flicks it away. Now he said. So chance for Darren Burnett to win the set with his last ball.
And this will be a good boost for his confidence here if he can draw this second shot to win this second set now. Just as Darren's got his act together over the last few ends.
Oh, that quacking.
Colin's taking the
mat Darren
back
Burnett.
Up with him to the top end.
Oh, the same back.
What they're doing it. Yeah.
Oh, back.
Take the mat back. Because he's
set score 9-5 after 8
Australia do the note.
Yeah.
Just take
Australia, New Zealand. Yeah, mat. They tend to just carry it up and down.
Zealand, yeah.
I thought they were shouting quack. I thought.
No. Well, the bingo's later.
I thought the bingo was going to go in the ditch.
Damn.
I told you I was deaf in one ear.
Yeah, it's at times I wished I'd been deaf in one ear at last week.
Shot length 24 metres.
Drives, yeah, causing arguments at home. Trust me.
Just I can imagine.
Oh, it's just my left ear, it's just completely dead. Can't hear a single thing through it at all. Joys of working on planes many years ago.
Ball by Darren, but you know it's that Colin needs to score 4 here. Tight set, obviously enough for Colin to win the match.
Pretty quick, but yeah, is he going to hit something?
Moves it right, so.
My goodness. I'm not quite sure if he played that or not.
Darren's still shot though with the back ball, his first back ball.
Yep, there you can see Darren Burnett's first delivery, probably 18 inches or so past the jack. If you can just grab the jack with this, that'll be excellent.
Yeah.
Well,
excellent ball from Darren
Two
Burnett.
Red.
Yep. Which means Colin's got 2 inches, 3 inches to draw the shot. Thank you.
Two shots, second set.
So into a tiebreak we go.
Match tiebreak.
This will be very interesting now. I mean, if Darren wins this toss, I think he may just elect to keep the jack himself.
Yeah, and keep the...
Darren has won the toss.
Doesn't know what to do.
Doesn't know what to do.
He's giving it away.
To give Colin the mat.
Giving it away, right, okay.
I'm like you, I thought he would have won the toss, he would have kept the jack to keep that minimum length.
Yeah, the mat up, Darren's not dominated it because he still struggled a little bit, but he's certainly the better consistent player on that that length.
Totally agree.
But sometimes, you know, you've still got that element of luck in bowls, haven't you? It doesn't matter how well you play an end. If someone's got the last bowl and they get a little bit of a fluke, should we call it, you've got no reply to that fluke.
Yeah.
Maybe that.
Yeah, and 28 and a half metres.
Very experienced, so he'll have a rough idea in his head what he's going to do.
Here.
One and a half inches through past Jack High.
No, and I think had Darren taken the jack there, I think I would have made him favourite for a tie break. I just hope he doesn't live to regret that decision. Colin giving himself
one green.
Best back ball.
Yeah, made two good balls in this first tie break.
Yeah, remember on the tie break, it's not about how many shots you score on the end, it's just whoever's nearest the jack wins that end.
Well, not far away. Out the rink he goes.
Jack's respotted. Darren will be line shot.
Yep, that's always the last thing that gets done. That indicates that play can resume.
One red.
And then the shot clock will start. What's his pace like? Because the line isn't too bad at all.
That's very good.
One green.
Just a meter.
One red.
Played Darren.
How short's my bowl, please?
Your bowl, 2.5 feet short of Jack High.
So, anything 18 inches to 2.5 feet, increase in pace
I'm
on
out.
That draw, we'll take that. I'm just... Is he looking at running the bowl away?
Colin has three timeouts remaining.
I mean, he's just played a great line. Just increase the pace slightly. Is he thinking of playing across it? He needs to decide. He's just sticking to the draw. So away it goes. Not far off the same line.
It's not here, I don't think.
No. Well, for the
one shot, Darren.
First
Burnett,
time in this game, Darren Burnett goes ahead. Colin Rogan will now have the choice whether he takes this jack or whether he gives it to Darren. If he gives it Darren, he knows where he's going, doesn't he? That's the thing. He may take it himself.
Yeah, he's going to take it himself.
Shot them 29 and a half metres.
Two and a half feet.
So Colin just looking to make slight adjustment here weight wise.
Given Darren too many chances there.
Yeah.
One red.
Yeah.
At least you can see it.
So see, it's still plenty of shots on there, you know, plenty of options still there. Down to the bowl. Down to the jack, movement in the jack,
yep.
To his own bowl, sat at the back.
Oh.
Time out. Colin, you have two timeouts remaining.
Just needs to try and just nail a good pace down this forehand. Well,
very close here.
Nearly got this. Oh! Wow.
Big effort there.
Very unlucky.
Timeout called. Darren, you have three timeouts remaining. Two red.
So that's to stay. And Imagine Cruising 2023 World Open Singles. What's his pace like?
Here again, you know. Just going to go wide again. Yep. Just the extra pace has kept it back.
Two red, second side right end, and match.
A little bit of a fright there for Darren Burnett, but he manages to scrape through in a tie break, 2-0. Well, let's have a little look then what we have coming up for the rest of today. So straight after lunch at 2 o'clock, it's Greg Harlow taking on the qualifier from the Newport Bowling Club, Jamie Walker. 3:45 will be Jamie Chesney taking on another UK qualifier from Atherley, John Wilson. And then in the evening game, it's 7:30 for Alex Marshall MBE against one of the sponsors' choice, Mr. Mark Royal. We'll be back with you at 2 o'clock. Thank you for joining us this morning. Until then, it's bye-bye for now.